Hello learners, we are moving to business environment. In this session, you will learn the recent developments in Indian economy, the concept of social responsibility of business and the concept of business ethics. First, I am saying about the business environment. Business environment is the sum total of all factors external to the business and greatly influence their functioning. When we are considering the recent developments of Indian economy, the economic environment of business in India has been changing at a fast rate, mainly due to changes in the economic policies of the government. During the time of independence, India was an agrarian economy. At that time, we had weak industrial base. To solve various economic problems and to speed up the industrial growth, governments took steps like state ownership on certain categories of industries, economic planning, and it reduced role of public sector. Likewise, the major developments which government took at that time was liberalization, privatization, and globalization. These was done by the government to speed the industrial growth. Liberalization refers to the process of eliminating unnecessary controls or unnecessary restrictions from the part of the government for the smooth functioning of business. Liberalization includes abolishing industrial licensing requirement in most of the industries. And liberalization also includes freedom in deciding the scale of business activities. That is, business can decide whether it can adopt for large scale or a small scale business unit. Similarly, as a result of liberalization, freedom in fixing of prices of goods and services came in the hands of manufacturers. Liberalization simplified the procedure of imports and exports. Liberalization reduced tax rates and it simplified policies to attract foreign capital, foreign technology to India, attracted foreign technology and capital towards India as a result of liberalization. Then coming to another major step taken by the government, privatization. Privatization refers to reducing the role of public sector and involving private sector in most activities. Privatization includes reduction in the number of industries reserved for the public sector. Earlier it was 17 and now it was reduced to 8 and reduced further to 3, and the introduction of selective competition in the reserved area. Earlier telecommunications were fully under the control of the government. Now you are using telephone sector which is operated by different private organizations. Privatization also includes disinvestment of shares of selected public sector industrial enterprises in order to raise resources and to encourage participation of public and workers in the ownership in business. That is, the shares earlier only with the government allowed general public participation in the shares or workers participation in the shares of the public sector enterprises so that their contribution will be more. Privatization also includes improvement in performance through memorandum of understanding system by which managements are to be granted greater autonomy. But management are held accountable for specified results. That is, great freedom is given to managements, but they are answerable if any failure is coming from their side or if their activities are not according to the needs of the Indian citizens. For that, they are answerable or accountable. Coming to another step taken by the government for the development of industries, that is globalization. It means integrating the economy of a country with the world economy. That is, this allowed, globalization allowed free flow of goods, free flow of services, free flow of technology and free flow of capital across national boundaries. That is, between nations. Nowadays, goods are moving from one country to another country. That is possible only with the help of globalization. If you want a product from any foreign country, you can use the internet and you can give the order and material will reach your place within days or months. So this happened because of the globalization. And how this technology also came to India because of the globalization. So that is the result of globalization. So, as a result of these changes in the business environment, you can notice in the business environment, rapidly changing technological environment as a result of privatization, globalization. Because of these effects, rapid changes in the technological environment. After the introduction of new economic policy, the companies were forced to adopt the world-class technology. And this resulted in increased competition. And nowadays, as a result of these major steps by the government, what you have noticed? More demanding consumers. Prior to government policy changes, consumers purchased what is available in our country, both goods and services, without much enquiry. Consumers have purchased from our country. Now, consumers demand. And according to their demand, products are produced. And consumers are expecting good quality products and nowadays they will buy good quality products only. So, according to the demand of the consumers, products are produced. Then coming to increased competition. As a result of these changes made by the government, increased competition is there in the Indian economy. Indian companies have to face severe competition, both inside the market, that is in the internal market, and from multinational corporations or MNCs. If the companies could not face the competition, they had to leave the market. This arose because of the globalization, privatization, etc. Before the government policy changes, the businesses were more stable. Policies, once laid down, were used to continue for a long time. At that time, that is before the policy changes, once a policy is made, it will continue for a long period of time. But now the situation has changed. Business environment undergo rapid change nowadays. One type of mobile phone will come within 6 months or 3 months. Like that, more apps are coming. More technology is being involved in each and every business field, as well as in every gadget, as well as the dealings with the consumers also. So the policies are changing every now and then because of the globalization effect. And we are forced to modify the policies from time to time. Necessity for developing human resources also emerged because of the latest economic policy or government's new policy. Prior to the government policy changes, Indian companies were managed by inadequately trained personnel, and new market situations demanded highly skilled and competent human resources. Earlier, whatever with a person, if a person is willing to work means he can work, he will be allowed to work, and then he will be given training. But nowadays the situation has changed. Only skilled persons, competent persons can work in the Indian setup. So, managed by inadequately trained personnel in earlier days. And Indian companies started training their human resources. Now, moving to social responsibility of business. Every business enterprise is an integral part of the society, and business uses its scarce resources, whatever it is, resources, land, labor, capital or organization, whatever it is using its scarce resources for its growth and for the long existence. No activity of business is injurious to the long run interest of the society. And what is social responsibility? Social responsibility of business means obligation to act in a manner which will serve the best interest of the society. Social responsibility is needed by every business organization. Why? Because, first point I would like to say, self-interest. Business can succeed in the long run by fulfilling the demands of the society. And good environment is needed, good opportunities for the employees are needed, then good education is also needed. So, these should be given to the employees. Good environment, even good education to the employees and good opportunities to the employees. Then the business will get good customers in the long run. Social responsibility is needed in every business organization, or it is a responsibility of every business to undertake social responsibility, because to balance social power. The decisions and activities of a business can affect the employees, decisions will affect the environment, and sometimes consumers will be affected with the decisions of the business, and the community, public will be affected with the business decisions. So, it is dealing with the society. Social, society means people. So, it has social power. It is the responsibility of the business to balance the interests of the employees, of the consumers, of the environment and the community, by taking its decisions wisely. Social responsibility is needed for every business unit because it is a creation of the society. Every business organization is a creation of the society. Why? Because it uses the resources provided by the society. In the society, whatever land is there, that is used by the business organization. Labor from the society organizations using. Capital from the society they are using. So, resource utilization should be done by every business organization for the benefit of the society. Social awareness. Nowadays, consumers are aware of price of different products, quality of the products, name of reputed companies. So, as they are aware of these things, every organization should be socially responsible. That will increase their reputation so that consumers will promote their product also through word of mouth promotion technique. Consumers should be given fair treatment. Otherwise, consumer association will perform or compel to perform social obligations. Will compel different organizations to perform social obligations. It is a responsibility of every business to be socially responsible, because to increase the public image, to increase the credibility of every organization, organizations should follow social obligations. What society needs, that should be followed by different business organization. What business should perform as a social responsibility? They should provide a product to the consumers. Good quality products should be produced and given at proper time. It should be given. No hoarding or black marketing should be done. Like that, there are certain obligations in the part of the business. These are done for increasing the public image and for increasing the credibility. That is, social obligations are done for increasing the public image and for increasing the credibility. So if a business follows social obligation, then public image will increase and credibility will increase. Moral justification. Every business organization uses physical resources, capital, power, water, human resources of the society. So business has a responsibility towards the society, and every business sells products to the society. So it has a moral responsibility for maintaining the well-being of the society. Let us discuss about the responsibility towards different interest groups, responsibility towards shareholders, towards employees, consumers, government and community. Business has responsibility towards owners. What responsibility? To provide fair return to the shareholders, to ensure safety of the investment of the shareholders, provide correct, regular and adequate information on the financial aspects, and to provide fair and regular dividend, and to protect the assets of the business. Towards employees, business has certain responsibility. That is, reasonable wages, fair wages should be provided. Either wages or salary you can categorize, because wages are given to the factory workers, salary for the administrative type of work. Good working conditions should be provided to the employees for the good health of the workers. And business should provide services like housing, medical care, recreation, etc. to the employees. And business should develop a sense of belongingness, that the employees are there. Like that is, belongingness should be created by every business unit. And cooperation of the workers should be made by creating better human relations in the business. It is a responsibility of every business unit to get the cooperation of the workers and to maintain good human relations inside the organization. Coming to responsibility towards consumers. Business should ensure regular supply of goods or services. Business should provide goods at a reasonable rate. It should provide goods which will help to meet the needs of the consumers of different classes. That is, variety of products should be provided to the consumers. And business should provide goods of standard quality. Business should ensure that the advertisements made are true. Prompt service must be provided by every business organization. Similarly, continuous service to the consumers. Business has certain responsibility towards the government. That is, it should abide by the laws of the nation, follow the laws of the nation, pay taxes honestly and in time. It should refrain from corruption of government employees. It should not indulge in any corruption activities. Business should discourage the tendencies of concentration of economic power and monopoly. Business should adapt fair dealings in foreign trade. Responsibility towards community. Business should protect the environment from pollution. Business should provide better employment opportunities. And it should preserve social values. Very important. Cultural values. It is the responsibility of the business to maintain these values. In what way? Why can't we prefer traditional type of things? That is good for our health in most of the cases. Earthen pots, like that, you have to identify, and you as a business unit should try to implement these in our society for the benefit of our society. And responsibility towards community also includes helping the weaker sections of the society, especially disabled persons, widows, scheduled tribes, etc. And business has the responsibility to promote national integration. Now let us move to business and environmental protection. Health of plants and animals will affect the quality of environment. As a result of rapid industrialization, fast food centers emerged in India, more traffic, and this has degraded the quality of Indian environment. Causes of environmental pollution. Air pollution. It is a result of a combination of factors which decreases the air quality. Water pollution. What all factors are decreasing the water quality? That is, water pollution. Chemical waste from factories is polluting the water bodies of our country. Not only that, people are also polluting the water by putting flowers, plastic bottles, etc. in the water and polluting our water, which will create serious damage to our environment and which will arise in the serious shortage of water. Nowadays, you are not paying for any water, but a stage, if it comes for getting pure water, if you want to pay, means it is a serious thing which you will not be able to afford, because daily you are taking how much liters of water, you count that. That is why be careful and maintain good environmental norms and behave like that. Another causes of environmental pollution is land pollution. Whatever is degrading the land quality, that is land pollution. Excessive usage of pesticides in agriculture has damaged our divine land. People throw these plastic bags here and there, causing pollution of our soil. Here I should mention one more thing as a pollution, that is noise pollution. Running of factories is a source of noise pollution. Cars or any other vehicle that is moving with the help of horns continuously is polluting or is creating noise pollution. Then loudspeakers. Noise pollution may cause mental disorder, loss of hearing, malfunctioning of heart. Even it will cause degradation of the eyesight. And what is the need for pollution control? Reduce safety hazards, and business organization has to ensure safety of life of the people working inside the organization and also the public. Business should reduce risk of liability to pay compensation to people. Business should protect public health. Business should reduce inconveniences like water pollution, human health hazards like breathing difficulty, irritation in eyes, etc. To save cost of cleaning the land and machines, that is, we need high cost to clean the land and machines, and if pollution control is there, we can save cost of cleaning the land and machines. Coming to business ethics, it means the business practices which are desirable from the point of view of the society. That is, it is the moral practices which should be followed by the business. Business should follow certain ethical practices, like it should charge fair prices from the customers, it should use fair weights for commodities, business should pay taxes to the government correctly and promptly, business should ensure supply of safe products for the public. It should give fair treatment to the workers, and it should not indulge in unfair trade practices, malpractices, black marketing and hoarding. Elements of business ethics. That is, business ethics creates self-imposed discipline on the part of business firms. It makes a business firm honest and responsible. Business ethics aims at fair and reasonable treatment to employees, customers, suppliers, etc. Business ethics coexists with law, which will help in the perfection of the conduct of life. Business ethics covers all business practices which are desirable from the point of view of the society. So, dear learners, we have learned the recent developments in Indian economy, concept of social responsibility of the business, and concept of business ethics. Hope you understood this session very well. Thank you.